Good morning, dear student. In the last session, we were discussed the significant figures and their rules and the rounding of that numbers and their rules, okay? And we had some numericals in both the concept, okay? So, in this session, we are going to discuss here one of the most important concept, that is, you know, conversions, okay? Suppose you have one particular unit that has to be get converted into other particular unit, guys, okay? So this is the thing we have to learn in this particular session. Let us go with this particular thing, guys, okay? So let us start with that. Here we have very first conversion factor, that is, okay, so convert 1 kilometer into centimeter. So convert 1 kilometer into centimeter, okay? So first of all, so our main agenda is to be here, we have to convert 1 kilometer into centimeter. So which means that 1 kilometer, okay, 1 kilometer. So kilo, which is nothing but here 10 to the power of 3 meter. And by the way, so while doing this particular concept, so you guys should have to know that here multiples and as well as that sub multiples, okay? So in order to get this particular concept better, you guys know these things, okay? So then only this particular conversion is going to be very easy, I must tell you that, okay? So 1 kilometer, that has to be get converted into centimeter, right? So here 1 kilo is the material 10 to the power of 3, and meter I just write as it is. So next, guys, 10 to the power of 3, okay? And what it is there here, centimeter. So centi, which is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. Centi is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 2, and meter is there, I just write it is as it is, okay? So guys, so our main intention is to be here convert 1 kilometer into centimeter. So we just make an here arrangement right now. What that particular arrangement means, so in order to cancel this particular number, we have to multiply this number with an here 10 to the power of 2, okay? So then what actually it becomes, okay, 10 to the power of 3 into 10 to the power of 2, okay? So which going to become here 10 to the power of 5, right? And so 10 to the power of minus 2, which is nothing but here centi, which is nothing but centi, which is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 2, right? So 10 to the power of minus 2, which is nothing but here centi, I just have it right here, see, and meter is to be there, meter, okay? See guys, if you can once, you know, solve these things, means ultimately you should get here original value here, 10 to the power of 3. See, if these two are cancelled, means then you are going to get here 10 to the power of 3 meter, okay? This value should not be altered after solving these things, okay? So after solving these things, you know, this value should not be altered, this value must be same, okay? See here, we got our conversion, 1 kilometer ultimately, which is equal to here 10 to the power of 5 centimeter, 10 to the power of 5 centimeter, okay? So this is the very simple thing, guys. So second one, so second conversion we have here, convert 1 nanometer into centimeter. Convert 1 nanometer into centimeter. Convert 1 nanometer into centimeter. So let us have here 1 nanometer. Okay, 1 nanometer, which is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 9 meter. Okay, 1 nanometer, which is equal to here 10 to the power of minus 9 meter. Okay, so then 10 to the power of minus 9 meter, and what we have to convert here, nanometer into centimeter. So again, you guys should write here, okay? So 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. So centi is the number here, 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. So again, in order to cancel this particular number, what we have to do here? So we have to multiply with an here 10 to the power of plus 2, 10 to the power of 2, 10 raise to 2 guys, okay? So 10 raise to 2, okay? So then see what it actual becomes, means see 10 to the power of minus 9 into 10 to the power of 2, which becomes here 10 to the power of minus 7, and again 10 to the power of minus 2, which is nothing but here centi, and meter is there, centimeter. So 1 nanometer which is equal to here, which is equal to 10 to the power of minus 7 centimeter. 10 to the power of minus 7 centimeter. So this, you know, this particular conversion can be done in other particular method. Okay, so 1 nanometer into centimeter. Okay, so 1 nanometer, which is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 9 meter, right? Okay, so I just have an here 10 to the power of minus, so 9 can be written as here 10 to the power of minus 7 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. Okay, is it wrong? Okay, no. So we just have to write it as well. Okay, 10 to the power of minus 7 and 10 to the power of minus 2, which is nothing but here centi and meter itself. So 10 to the power of minus 7 centimeter. So 1 nanometer, so which is equal to here 10 to the power of minus 7 centimeter, guys. So this is a very simple, so you know, conversion factor we have here. Okay, let us take down. So all those things, guys. Okay, very simple. So take a screenshot also. Okay, let us go with that here. Third conversion factor. So convert 1 megameter into gigameter. So 1 megameter into gigameter. So convert 1 megameter into gigameter. 1 megameter into gigameter. So yes. So by the way, guys, 1 mega meter. So 1 megameter, which is nothing but here 10 to the power of 6 meter, guys. 10 to the power of 6 meter. So mega, which is nothing but here multiple. Giga is also multiple, right? Okay, so mega is 10 to the power of 6, giga is 10 to the power of 9. Okay, so and 1 gigameter. So 1 gigameter, which is nothing but here 10 to the power of 9 meter. Isn't it? So 1 megameter, which equals to 10 to the power of 6 meter, means, so our main intention is to be here, we have to convert 1 megameter into gigameter. So then what the stuff we have to follow here? So 10 to the power of 6 meter, okay, 10 to the power of 6 is there here, okay, and we have to convert into gigameter, means, so giga is nothing but here 10 to the power of 9 meter. 10 to the power of 9 meter. So, but the thing is that, guys, in order to cancel this particular number, we have to multiply. So, this number with an here, 10 to the power of minus 9. Okay, once these values are cancelled, means you should get here that actual value, that is 10 to the power of 6. And this value should not be altered after solving these three things. Okay, after solving these numbers, means then this value should not be altered. Okay, if it is altered, means our method is going to be wrong. Okay, so that's why when we have to, you know, solve these numbers and the value what you are going to get, that now that value should be same with this particular value. Okay, so that's why, see, if you can cancel, means again you are going to get here 10 to the power of 6 meter. Okay, there is no issues with that, which is right one. So, and again, if you can simplify these two, 10 to the power of 6 into 10 to the power of minus 9, means you are going to get here 10 to the power of minus 3. 10 to the power of minus 3. And 10 to the power of 9 is nothing but here giga, okay, and meter is there meter. So 10 to the power of 9, which is nothing but here giga, okay, and meter is there. So that's why 1 megameter, which is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 gigameter. Okay, 1 megameter, which is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 gigameter. Very simple, guys. So you just practice it and you guys get this particular thing. Okay, so just take it down. So let us have that next one. Okay, so guys, let us convert here. You know, we have a formula, that is, you know, conversion of degree Fahrenheit into degree Celsius, or a degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit. So now we have that. So conversion, that is to convert so A 15 degree Celsius, B 10 degree Celsius, 10 degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit. Into degree Fahrenheit. So to convert 15 degree Celsius and 10 degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit. And by the way, we have a formula in order to convert. So degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit, that is, so degree Fahrenheit, which is equal to here. So 9 by 5 into degree Celsius, okay, plus 32, right? So this will be the formula we have here. Suppose in order to convert, so degree Fahrenheit into degree Celsius means here, so degree Celsius, which equals to, so degree Fahrenheit minus 32 into 5 by 9. So this will be the formula we have here. Okay, so ultimately we have these two formula. So whether we have to convert degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit means we just have to go with this particular so formula. In order to convert degree Fahrenheit into degree Celsius means that we just have a formula, that one. Okay, so we have here that, you know, question is to be here, we have to convert 15 degree Celsius and 10 degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit. So let's go with that here, 15 degree Celsius, by the way. So very first A, okay, so which is 15 degree Celsius, right? Let us have this formula, degree Fahrenheit, which equals to 9 by 5 into degree Celsius plus 32. So what are the formula we have? So this will be the formula, right? And the degree Celsius, so how many degree Celsius is there here? 15 degree Celsius they are given, okay. So let us substitute that value. Very simple, right? Okay, so 9 by 5 into degree Celsius means nothing but here 15 degree, okay, 15 degree into, so plus 32, okay. So 5 ones are 5 threes, okay, so 9 threes are 27 plus 32, so how much we are going to get here? 59 degree Fahrenheit, guys. Okay, so we are going to get here. So ultimately here, see, 15 degree Celsius supposed to be, if you are, you know, that express in terms of degree Fahrenheit means will be 59 degree. Okay, suppose let us go with that here reverse case, right? Suppose degree Fahrenheit into degree Celsius, or let us convert here degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit means, so let us substitute this value in that particular formula, you are going to get here degree Celsius as an 15 degree Celsius. Let us do that particular thing also. Okay, so degree Celsius, which equals to, so degree Fahrenheit, that is nothing but here 59 minus 32 into 5 by 9. Okay, so 59 minus 32 is nothing but here 27, 5 by 9. Okay, 9 ones are, 9 threes are, so 3 into 5, which is nothing but here degree Celsius, right? So this will be the conversion factor, guys. Okay, so whatever the value you are going to get in terms of degree Celsius, suppose in order to convert to degree Fahrenheit means you are going to get here specific value, guys. Okay, so this is the thing, guys, we have to know here while converting. So degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit or degree Fahrenheit into degree Celsius means we should have to know these two set of a formula here. Okay, so in order to find out this value means, so this is the must, that is, we have to know these particular formulas. So you just keep in your mind, guys. Okay, so let us go with that some different another particular conversion we have. Okay, so 10 degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit. So again, we have degree Fahrenheit, which equals to, so what is that formula we have? That 9 by 5 and 10 degree plus 32. 5 ones are, 5 twos are, 9 twos are 18 plus 32. Okay, so 48. So what is that value? That is 50, right? So we are going to get here 50 degree Celsius. So 50 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, 50 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, so this will be the conversion factor we always been know, guys. Okay, so let us take down all this conversion factor. So we have that some other particular conversions. Let's take it down, guys. Okay, Next, let us go with that here. So convert. So convert. So 5 feet. 5 feet. 2 inches. 2 inches in meter. In meter. 5 feet. 2 inches in meter. Okay. So by the way, guys. Okay. So 1 feet. 1 feet which equals to 1 feet which equals to here, which is nothing but 12 inches. 12 inches. Okay, so 12 inches, right? Suppose okay, and 1 inch which equal to 2.54 centimeter. 2.54 centimeter. So, and our main intention is to be here 5 feet 2 inches in meter we have to convert, right? So, let us go with that thing. Okay. So, 5 feet means 5 feet 2 inches, okay, which equals to 5 feet, by the way, 5 into 12 inches plus 2 inches. Okay, so 5 12 60 inches plus 2 inches. So overall value you are going to get here 62 inches, guys. Okay, 62 inches. Suppose 1 inch is to be here 2.54 centimeter, means so what might be the value you are going to get for 62 inches? So 62 into 2.54 centimeter means 1 inch which is equal to 2.54 centimeter, means so 62 inches might be on here. 62 into 2.54 centimeter, then that value we are going to get here 157.48 centimeter, guys. 157.48 centimeter. 157.48 centimeter. Okay, so again guys, centi which is nothing but here, okay, centi 157.48 centi, which is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. Centi is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 2, right? So and meter as it is here. Suppose so in order to shift that value, means if you can, you know that so divide these values with that this particular, you know, by 100, means you are going to get here 1.5748 meter. Okay, ultimately we got here, so 5 feet 2 inches, 2 inches in terms of in terms of meter means 1.5748 meter. Okay, so this will be the conversion, guys. See, 1 feet which is equal to 12 inches. 1 inch supposed to be you are converting into centimeter means 2.54 centimeter. So 5 feet 2 inches means 5 into 12 inches plus 2 inches. Okay, so why? Because 1 feet which is equal to here 12 inches, that's why 5 feet which is equal 5 into 1 feet which is the number 12 inches. Okay, in order to simplify this value, ultimately you are going to get here 62 inches. So for an 1 inch if you are converting centimeter means 2.54 centimeter, for a 62 inches it would be here, so 1.54 into 48 centimeter. So in order to converted into a meter means, so centi is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 2, and it will be converted as an here meter. So thereby if you are, you know, shifting a point means, so decimal point means, ultimately you are going to get here 1.5748 meter. So this will be the overall result, guys. Okay, so let us go with that here. Next one, you know, so express, let us you know, that take down that particular, so conversions. So well, let us go with that here. So express 500 nanometer into angstrom. into angstrom, 500 nanometer into angstrom. So 500 nanometer into angstrom, our main agenda is now. Okay, so then the thing is that let us take down 500 nanometer. Okay, so 500 nanometer is nothing but here 5 into 10 to the power of 2 into 10 rise to minus 9 meter. Why? Because 1 nanometer, which is nothing but here, how many meter? So 1 nanometer, which is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 9 meter. Okay, that's why 500 is number 5 into 10 to the power of 2. Okay, and nano is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 9 meter. Okay, so but our main intention is that here we have to convert nanometer into angstrom. So let us take down 5 into 10 to the power of 2. Okay, and so what is that angstrom? 1 angstrom will be 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. Okay, so that's why angstrom is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 10. Minus 10 meter. Okay, in order to cancel this number, we have to again multiply with an year 10 to the power of 10, guys. Okay, then what will be the answer we are going to get ultimately here? Okay, yes, we have, okay, and 10 to the power of minus 9 and 10 to the power of 10 into 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. Suppose once you can simplify these values, means you are going to get ultimately this value, guys. You know, so 10 to the power of 10 and 10 to the power of minus 10 get cancelled. Again, you are going to get here the same value what you have in this particular case. Okay, so very simple, right? So you just simplify these three things. Simplify these three. Okay, so 5 and 10 to the power of minus 9, 10 to the power of 10 means nothing but here 10. So which becomes 10 to the power of 3, 10 to the power of 2. And here 10 will be remains, okay, by cancelling these two. Okay, so which becomes 10 to the power of 3. Okay, then 10 to the power of minus 10 is nothing but here angstrom meter. So 10 to the power of minus 10 is nothing but here angstrom. Okay, 1 angstrom is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 10 meter, right? So 10 to the power of minus 10 meter is nothing but here angstrom, guys. So 500 nanometer, which equals to 5 into 10 to the power of 3 angstrom, guys. Yes, so ultimately we got that value here. Let us go with that second conversion. So convert 6000 angstrom into picometer. Convert 6000 angstrom into picometer. Convert 6000 angstrom into picometer. Okay, so we have here 6000 angstrom, right? So 1 angstrom we know very well, that is minus 10 meter, and 1 picometer will be equal to 10 to the power of minus 12 meter, as we know that. Okay, so 1 angstrom which equals 10 to the power of minus 10 meter, so thereby 6000 angstrom which equals to 6 into 10 rise to 3 and 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. Okay, 6, see, so look at carefully here, 6 into 10 rise to 3, because 6000 is there and angstrom is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. So now we have to convert this factor into picometer, right? So we just made an arrangement here, 10 to the power of 3 minus 10, and so what is that picometer here? So 10 to the power of minus 12 meter, isn't it? So ultimately, guys, ultimately, suppose in other words, if you can see that here, suppose in order to cancel this particular number, we have to again multiply here 10 to the power of 12. So then what would be the value you are going to get ultimately here? Okay, so 10 to the power of 3 and 10 to the power of, so 10 to the power of 12 and 10 to the power of 3 is nothing but here, which becomes 15. Okay, so 15, and again you are going to get here ultimately, yes, what would be the value you are going to get? So yes, do one thing here. Okay, So 10 to the power of minus 10 is there, no? So in order to make it as an here, minus 12, we have to multiply with that here, minus 2. Okay, in order to cancel this particular number, we have to again go through with that here, multiply here 10 to the power of 2, guys. So then what it becomes here, ultimately, okay, 6 into 10 to the power of 3 is there, and 10 to the power of minus 10, minus 12 is to be here nothing but minus 10 and minus 2 is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 12, and 10 to the power of 2 meter we have, and you just add up these two things, guys. 6 into 10 to the power of 10 to the power of 5, okay, and 10 to the power of minus 12 meter we had here. 6 into 10 to the power of 5 and 10 to the power of minus 12 meter, which is nothing but here picometer. Then we got here our actual result in terms of picometer is nothing but 6 into 10 raised to 5. Okay, so 6000 angstrom, which equals to, so 6 into 10 raised to 5 picometer, guys. Okay, very simple thing, right? Okay, so let us go with that here. Again, conversion factor we have. So convert 1 nanometer into here angstrom. Okay, so convert 1 nanometer into an angstrom. Let us take down this. Okay, so the thing is that what I have just, you know, that done here. So our main intention is to be here 6000 angstrom into picometer. We have to convert, right? So you just, write it like it, as it is, you know that. So 6 into 10 to the power of 3 and angstrom is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. Okay, so we have this particular value, and in order to make it as an here picometer, I just have to, you know, that multiply with that here minus 2. In order to cancel this number, then I just, you know, multiply with that here 10 to the power of 2. If you can, one simplify means you got this original value here. Okay, so these will be cancelled and you are going to get here the same value. Okay, so then ultimately, if you can add up these two things, 10 to the power of minus 10 and minus 2 will become here minus 12. Okay, 6 into 10 raised to 3 minus 12, and you got here 10 to the power of 2 meter. Okay, so if you can add up these two things, you got here 10 to the power of 5 and 10 to the power of minus 12 meter as it is. Okay, so as we know that 1 picometer, which is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 12 meter, we have here. Okay, so 10 to the power of minus 12 meter is nothing but here 1 picometer. So will be converted. So from that angstrom into picometer. Okay, so this will be the thing, guys. Next, go with that most important. So conversion, that's also very simple. Convert here. Let us convert. Convert 1 nanometer into, convert nanometer to angstrom. Convert nanometer to angstrom. As we know that, guys, right? 1 nanometer is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 9 meter, isn't it? Okay, so 10 to the power of minus 9 we have, and angstrom, which is nothing but here. So okay, angstrom is nothing but 10 to the power of minus 10, right? Minus 10 meter. So in order to make it as an here minus 10, we have to multiply here minus 1. Okay, in order to cancel this number, we have to multiply by here 10. Okay, if you can add up these two things, 10 to the power of minus 10, okay, so meter, because meter we have to write meter here, okay, and 10 meter we have that, isn't it? The same thing I have here right now. Okay, 10 to the power of minus 9 we have. If you can simplify these two things, means you got this particular value. 10 into 10 to the power of minus 1 get cancelled, again you got 10 to the power of minus 9 meter as it is. So after simplify these numbers, okay, this value should not be altered, this value should be same. Okay, so again 10 into 10 to the power of minus 10 meter, okay, so 1 angstrom will be equal to 10 to the power of minus 10 meter, right? So that's why 10 to the power of minus 10 meter is nothing but here angstrom. So 1 nanometer always be equal to here 10 angstrom. Let us take down, and you guys do some conversion I have. Okay, so and let us convert one the last but not the least factor is there, so which is, take down guys. Yes, well, we have here. Okay, so converting converting kg meter cube into gram cm cube. Okay, so the thing is that 1 kg meter cube. Okay, so 1 k is made here kilo, right? 10 to the power of 3 gram, and meter cube I just write as it is. Okay, so guys, as we know that here, so one meter is nothing but here 10 to the power of 2 centimeter, right? 1 meter is nothing but here 10 to the power of 2 centimeter. Okay, so 1 meter cube is nothing but here 10 to the power of 6 centimeter cube. Do you agree with this? Obviously, 1 meter is nothing but here 10 to the power of 2 centimeter means, for 1 meter cube, how much it will be? Okay, 10 to the power of 6 centimeter cube. Suppose if you can write it is 1 meter cube, which equals to, okay, 1 by m cube means 1. So 1 upon meter cube means nothing but here 10 to the power of 6 cm cube. So from denominator to numerator, if you can send means that, if you can have that, so per meter cube, which equals to 10 to the power of minus 6 into per centimeter cube. Okay, per meter cube you got here 10 to the power of minus 6 cent per centimeter cube. Okay, so that's why 10 to the power of 3 gram meter cube is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 6 cm cube per cm cube. Okay, so if you can simplify, so 10 to the power of 3 minus 10 to the power of minus 6 is nothing but here 10 to the power of minus 3 gram per cm cube. Okay, so that's why 1 kg meter cube, which equals to 10 to the power of minus 3 gram per cm cube. Okay, so if you can see here, in other words, if you can, in other method, if you can simplify this value means, so is an, you know that in form of reciprocal, if you can take here, kg divided by meter cube, right? So kg is nothing but here 10 to the power of 3 gram. Meter cube is nothing but here 10 to the power of 6 cm cube, right? If you can send these value into that, so numerator means 10 to the power of 3 gram, 10 to the power of minus 6 into cm per cm cube. So then value will be here 10 to the power of minus 3 gram per cm cube. Okay, so this is the thing, guys. So which is most important and very easy at the same time. Okay, so this is the thing. So let us take down. So for you guys, I have some that conversion factor. So do try it. Okay, don't ignore that. Okay. Let's go with that here for you guys. Okay, homework. Okay, so since you are in home, you just have to do that. Okay, so 1 kilometer to millimeter and millimeter to picometer. Okay, so second one, 1 milligram to kg and kg to nanogram. Okay, so then 1 ml to liter. Okay, so do try these particular conversion. Okay, so which are very simple, by the way, and don't bother about these things. Okay, so do practice well, guys. Okay, so and I'm just going to winding up this session. Okay, thank you, one and all.